Let's see this question asked in the IITJ paper 2013 for 3 marks. Now this question says area bounded by the curves y is equal to under root x 2y minus x plus 3 is equal to 0, x axis and in the first quadrant is what, right? So you have to compute the area. There might be options, I am not writing the options. Let's start solving it. So for such type of questions, first you have to make the diagram as to how would the actual curves look like. So if I say that this is my coordinate axis, then I know that this should be my y-axis, this should be my x-axis, and this should be my origin. Now y is equal to under root x 2y minus x plus 3 equal to 0, two equations, two unknowns y and x, let's solve for them. So I write solution, and you see that if my y is equal to under root x is equation number 1, if 2y minus x plus 3 equal to 0 is equation number 2, directly I can use 1 for 2. So 2 into y minus x plus 3 is equal to 0, so it becomes minus x plus 2 root x plus 3 equal to 0. Let me take minus sign common, so x minus 2 root x minus 3 is equal to 0, right? So if my x is equal to t square, or I can say my root x is equal to t, I can solve this equation. So I write t square minus 2t minus 3 is equal to 0. Now what would be the factors? T square minus 3t plus t minus 3 is equal to 0, t into t minus 3, and plus 1 into t minus 3 is equal to 0. So t is equal to 3 and minus 1. These are the two roots. But t was what? Root x. So cannot be negative. So t is equal to under root 3. If t is equal to under root 3, sorry, if t is equal to 3, if t is equal to 3, so my x is what? 9, because x is what? T square. So it is 9. Now when x is known to us, what is my y? So my y is equal to 3 from 1. So see, we have solved for x and y. So that means what? That means these are the values that I am getting. And I must say that when I draw the curves, I mean 2y minus x plus 3 is equal to 0. So here it must be something like 3. And the line, straight line, will be drawn somewhat like this. You know how to plot the lines, right? It is nothing but can be put in the slope intercept form also. So it is like this. So somewhere maybe here it would be minus 3 by 2 and so on. You can see what are the points of intersection automatically on your own. Now as you see that y is equal to under root x is also there. Now y is equal to under root x means what? Definitely it would be something like, let me see what is my x, what is my y. If x is 0, y is 0. First point. If x is 1, y is 1. So there would be a point 1, 1. Then if x is say 9, then my y is 3. But before that, if my x is 4, y is 2. So see, there is something like x is 4 and then y is just increasing like this. Then you have x is 9 and y is just like this. So it is increasing in some manner. And you also have to see their point of intersection, which is nothing but 9, 3. So I can directly plot the graph and I know that the point of intersection would be say 9, 3. I'm not drawing it as a whole, but I know that. And what do I have to compute? I have to compute this shaded area. I've done it in a very rough manner just to make you understand. That was the straight line. This is the curve, right? Now, you have to find out the area bounded by these two curves, the x-axis and the first quadrant, means the shaded area. So the required area is the shaded area. And how do we find the shaded area? From integration 0 to 3, x2 minus x1 dy. That is your a, or that is your I. So x2 minus x1, x2 means from here this is x2, this is x1. So what is my value? my value is 2y plus 3 integration dy from 0 to 3 minus x1. Now what is x1? It is y square from 0 to 3 dy. What should be the answer? 2 into y square by 2 plus 3y. Put the limits from 0 to 3 minus y cube by 3. Put the limits from 0 to 3. What is the answer? See, this 2 and 2 gets cancelled. Now, 3 square is 9. I'm just solving it here. 3 square is 9 plus 3 threes is again 9. Then put minus, vanishes. Then here it is minus sign. 3 cube is 27 upon 3, which is 9. And you know, 0 vanishes. So 9 square units should be my answer to this question. So this is how you solve it. First, you're going to find out the points of intersection. You're going to draw the graph, make a bit of understanding, and then proceed further.